Hey everybody, Ann here. It's way past coffee and you get a different view today because I'm sitting here in front of my little desk thingy trying to work on my Linux laptop. It's giving me fits and I can't get the camera to work, so I don't know. I was hoping to be able to do some filming with like sitting in front of my laptop, like live streaming, but I don't think it's going to happen. So I've been doing some relaxing, some communing with nature, and some hard work too. So I'm going to show you some of the stuff I've been harvesting right and left. I've canned some more stuff, and yeah, so, but this next week is going to be super hot again. I mean, we're talking, the starting temperature is going to be in the hundreds, but the heat index is going to have it up to 110, 115, so it's going to be crazy. But here, let me show you the stuff that I've been picking. I've got a ton of tomatoes, ton of jalapeno peppers. Look at this big juicy one. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. But yeah, so I need to do some more canning here pretty quick with these ones that are ripe. These are all gonna ripen pretty quick. I've made another jar of salsa, another pickled summer squash, and oh yes, I did make another jar of, here, let me show you. Another jar of mock pineapple. Yep, I had enough for two jars, but I didn't can the other one. And in the other one, I mixed some shredded coconut, unsweetened coconut, and I'm gonna put it over cottage cheese. But yeah, this stuff is absolutely wonderful. And here's the other salsa that I did. It's in a non-cannable jar. I'm not gonna can it. It's just really easy to do, and I love the flavor of it. So this one has a couple more days, and yeah, it'll be done. Let's go see the bunnies. See that? Yep, a lot of bunny compost because I cleaned out the bunny hutch. Yeah, there's some cool cold water in there. I need to replace it here in a couple minutes. But I got their hutch and the inside nice and clean, new bedding. I still have a blue tarp here, but on the outside I put this down for the shade so it wouldn't be such an eyesore. I don't really like the blue tarps because they're just so yucky looking from the street. So, yeah. And then in here, I got a lizard up over there. I don't know if you can see, but I put a little box. Hi, bunny. Well, hello, you sweet baby. Hello. I just tried to make a little hutch for them. And out of a cardboard box, and I put some bedding back in there. I put a combination of, well, mostly shredded paper that Miss Donna had brought down. I have some more left that I didn't use for fire starters yet. So I put some shredded paper back in there. I can see they've been in there because they've kind of kicked it out a little bit. So I don't know if they'll use that to give birth in, but all I know is they're mating. So, oh, look at you. You are just so sweet. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to eat these. I don't know. I don't know, you guys. I have been chopping up wood like crazy. I'm going to take it back in there, but I'm not going to. I'll talk over it because I'll turn the sound down because the generator's going and it's really loud. But I've been increasing my wood stack. Some have come from my property. A couple of them have come from Mr. Lucas. He has a neighboring property that a contractor took down a bunch of trees. Well, he scooped them up, put them in the shade over on Mr. Lucas' property. So I've been going over there, chopping up some for me, chopping up some for him. And that little chainsaw is a beast. This is the stuff from before. That's the cedar. And these two stacks are that poplar that I cut up. There's some more poplar down on the bottom there, but behind it is red oak. I may have that backwards. I don't know, but a lot of the stuff that I cut up off Mr. Lucas is red oak, and it's really hard and it's going to burn great. So I want to get this whole area filled with wood, just stacked up as high as I can get it, because I'm going to need it this winter. I have a feeling. I've harvested a couple of zucchini, a couple of yellow summer squash, the patty pan. I will see a patty pan and then the next day it will disappear. And the blooms are starting to rot on some of the squash plants. So I don't know what that's all about, but let's go see what the baby chickens are doing. Hello, baby chickens. They're all kind of chilling out. Yeah, I've got two things of water. They like to get up and walk in their water, so I got to get out here a few times a day and clean it up. But they are growing like crazy. Yes, they are. And they've been going up into the coop every night all by themselves. Look at that rooster. Oh my gosh, you guys, it is so oppressively hot out here. And one thing about this heat is it's not cooling down a lot at night. Like last night, I just let the generator run until it ran out of propane. I'm not going to be able to do that tonight and every night, because every time I go to get propane, it's about $35 for both tanks. So, I don't know. I just keep praying for cooler weather. But I got to accept my blessings where I can take them. I've got air conditioning, so at least there's that. And, well, Papa, he's a good boy here. Let me show you. Papa has learned that even if I don't have the air conditioner on, it is cooler inside here than it is outside, even if it's like 85, 86 degrees inside this tiny house. Definitely cooler than outside because there's not the same humidity levels. But he's been a good boy, and he's doing good going on his walks with me and not trying to escape. You're a good boy. Anyway, something weird, kind of weird, happened today. It would seem like nothing to most of you, but to me it was kind of like a big deal. You know, I keep the chain at the end of the road down there. It used to have a sign, but the sign has fallen off, so I need to get some attachments so I can hook it back up to the chain. Well, someone came up all the way to my door and went in through my gated area and came all the way to my front door, knocked on my door, and well, it's a neighbor that doesn't live on my street, and he gave me his name. But there's what made me uncomfortable is that, well, he came over asking if anybody had been stealing from me, because he said he'd had stuff stolen from him. And I said, no. He says, have you seen anybody on your property? I'm like, no, you know, just you. And, you know, we got to talk, and I reassured him that if I saw anybody, I would let him know. He said he had some stuff stolen. So his first thing was, have you seen anybody on your property, because I've had some things stolen. And then a little bit later in the conversation, he talked about, you know, I told him, well, I've got security cameras and I've got security lights and stuff like that. And he said, oh yeah, I have security cameras. And I didn't really think about that until I was on the phone talking to my friend Denise. And I thought, why would he be coming up on my property asking if I had seen anybody, because he had some stuff stolen, if he had security cameras? Because if he had security cameras, then he would know who's up on his property. He wouldn't need to come all the way up onto mine without permission. So I don't know. Maybe it's just I'm overthinking this, but I kind of feel like there's some dishonesty going on there, because if you truly had security cameras, then you wouldn't need to come up and ask me if I had seen anybody. So, yeah, the whole conversation, it seemed nice. It seemed well. I showed him my chickens and, you know, but it could be just a concerned neighbor. It could be somebody coming up casing the joint. It could be maybe he just wanted to see what was going on over here. I don't know. He asked me about the neighbor family and, you know, who are they? And I'm like, they're good people. The guy's a hard worker, and he's a genius at building stuff. He's a good man. So I shut down that conversation right away. I don't know. I just, you know, you either have security cameras and they were on and you know who was stealing, or you don't have security cameras, or but there's no need to lie about something like that. Unless you're up to no good. Anyhow, so we'll just kind of see how that's going to go. Anyhow, not a lot else is going on. Like I said, I've chopped down wood, cut it apart. I chopped up some for Mr. Lucas because his chainsaws are on the fritz. I split up and stacked up all that wood, just trying to tend the garden and tend the chickens and the rabbits. And we had a couple cool days, but it's back to being the oppressive heat. So no, I'm trying to stay positive and just keep going, and well, we'll see. So I'm gonna go get something cold to drink, and that's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.